Good morning. As I leave the firs, so that's where I stayed last night. It was very, very welcoming. Very nice, bed was comfy. Then a little let down was the telly. The telly didn't tune into many channels. You couldn't get BBC One, BBC Two, but I'm not really here for the telly. It's just nice to do something in the evening, I suppose. But yeah, very nice. Expensive, but very nice. So today we're heading to Kington. It's about 16 miles, I think. We start off by walking through Hay and down and across the bridge over the river, and then we're on the way. I am going to nip into the spa. There's a spa shop that I'm going to pass in a second as well, and see if I can get some pack up for the day. So it's another beautiful morning, a bit cooler this morning. I am out a bit earlier though. It's 20 to 8, so I left 10 minutes ago. There we go, 14 and 3 quarter miles today. Nice little table and chairs there, well, that's different. And a bear's bum under the tree. Some easy going early on today, just some low walking around the edges of farmers' fields or through farmers' fields. Come on, can I come through? Come on, back. I'm coming this way. You just keep going back and I'm coming this way. Come on, back it up. You go that way, I'm coming through here. Good girl. Keep going, that's it. There we go, no problem. He says with his bright red t-shirt on. Charge! A nice bit of shaded walking through this little glen was probably what was required today after the sunburn yesterday. I do come out of it in a couple of miles though, and then I think I go back up into the open. It is supposed to be a bit more overcast later on, so that may help too if it does actually happen. But yeah, nice going at the minute. This is looking back. I'm just walking along a road section, I'll show it in a second. But I assume one of these ridges is where I was yesterday. Good views back today. So I've been climbing up for the last sort of 30 minutes, but I've hit a road section which has leveled out a bit now. Okay, I'm leaving that road now. Look out for DHL drivers when you're walking along there. It ain't very wide. I'm just about to go through this gate then and into the open, and I think that will be me out in the sun again for the rest of the day. Quite a nice little track lined with trees. The sun has just nipped behind a cloud. It is starting to cloud over, which can only be beneficial to me, as much as I love the sun. Quite nice here. That's back again to the views behind, but now I've got views opened up this side. And some views up ahead and over this side. The path continues up there. I'm at the church. It says it's open for tea and coffee. I might just go and have a quick look. I'm not necessarily going to buy anything. I don't want any tea or coffee, but donation box on the wall. Let's have a look, and I better sign the visitor's book. Somebody did it yesterday. Let's have a look, what we're the 9th today. So I'll have a little, please write on both pages, that's fine, I'll start there in a minute. So we've got some juice, tea, coffee, cups, some ginger nuts, some custard creams, some sweets. It's not a vast amount, there's some water up there. Might have a quick glass of orange juice actually, what is it? Orange and mango. I'll have a little glass of that while I'm here. And there's a little money pot there, look for donations. Very good. There we go, just a little note. Uphill section as you climb out of New Church. I've just come up through this gate. New Church was down there where them houses are. You can just see the church through these two trees, just somewhere just to the side of this tree. But yeah, the climb continues. Yeah, it was a tough climb that. Right down there again, New Church. Big climb out of there. It's leveled off a bit again now, but still going up. I'm just gonna take this very small detour. I don't think there's any trig up here, but this is the top of the hill. So I'm just gonna climb up to there just to see if the views are worth it really. Oh, it was worth it, wasn't it? I think so. Alright, 360, which way should we go? Let's go that way for a change. So you can see the low path just down there. I don't really know why they don't just send you over here. I think then I'm at the highest point on, I'm really sorry because this is going to be totally incorrectly pronounced, Disgwylfa Hill. I tell you what, I've walked through some farmyards and close to some fields in my time and smelt some awful smells, but I've never smelt anything that stinks as bad as whatever this smell is I can smell now. It is vile. Kington 4.5 miles. I've spied a bench, it's 12 o'clock. That sounds like a good time to me to stop and have it's not a sandwich. And it's not a sandwich because there weren't any sandwiches in the spa shop in Hay this morning. There we go, raspberry splits. There's pancakes with a raspberry filling. There's 6 in there. If they're nice, I'll probably get through the lot. I must apologise, I called them pancakes. They're Welsh cakes. Welsh cakes with a raspberry jam filling. They're actually quite nice. Now, I knew there was a pub, but I was assuming it was going to be short. It is actually open. So what you could do is forget buying sandwiches back in Hay and nip to the pub there for some lunch. I've decided to skip it though and not go for a pint. Obviously I've just had my lunch on that bench and I had a big guzzle of Lucozade and whatever there, finished that off. So I do like a pint at the end of the day, but I'm not a big fan of drinking mid-walk. I always get dry mouth if I do that. So yes, I've avoided the pub. I'm carrying straight on. And yeah, 4.5 miles left to go. Quite a brutal climb straight down this track here. You can't see, but it's quite steep and hard going. The views are just starting to open up again. I expect they'll get better yet as we head up this lot. Quite a lot of these little stone markers along the way. again a look back. The views are really starting to open up. Still more to climb yet though. The views now are more to this side, the old quarry down there. There's a bit of a split in the path here. The Offa's Dyke actually follows that path and then goes right up ahead. But I'm taking this one because this one goes a bit more direct to the trig. The path actually bends round the trig point, so it doesn't reach the summit of Hergus Ridge here, but I'd rather just tick off the trig point and reach the summit while I'm here. This is the highest point on Hergus Ridge at 426 metres. The trig point is dead ahead, but it's actually 3 metres lower, but it might offer better views looking at the landscape in the background. So let's just do a 360 while I'm here. That is back to the Black Mountains, Brecon Beacons, where I was yesterday. That is where I've come from, somewhere over that direction. But yeah, pretty impressive views from here. But I think they might be better from that trig point. Voila, views exceptional. Slightly closer to the edge. The drop down is now beginning. I can see a little town, is it, or village, or whatever it is down there. So I'm assuming that's Kington where I'm heading. So the guidebook today said that today's walk could rival yesterday's. For me, not close. Yes, these views are pretty epic. They are, but this has only been for the last mile. Whereas yesterday, it was all the way along the ridge. Okay, it came and went in places. But yeah, for me, Hatterall Ridge far outweighs Hergus Ridge. This sign is at the bottom then of Hergus Common. I don't know if it's Hergus or Hergus, to be honest. I've been saying Hergus, so I'll keep saying that. So I've dropped down off that path and then we leave the common through the gate and we've got 1 mile left to go today. Here I am at Hergus Croft Gardens then. It says the tea room is open. Obviously this is here, this is what I've come for. Right, so the first four I got are now here. So that's that one. Let's do it. Comments book. Right, this is a record of who is passing through the Offa's Dyke Path Hergus Croft marker point. Enjoy the rest of your walk. Best wishes, the Offa's Dyke Centre. So I haven't seen one of these in any of the others. This dates back to 2019. April 2019. Right, so we'll add date and time, a name. Direction of travel. Okay, stamp got. it's only 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so I am going to check out this garden centre and just, why not, while I'm passing through, we'll have a look and get a drink from here, or whatever they've got, we'll have a look. Alright, so I've just got myself a drink and a caramel slice. What I would say is it's not cheap, that caramel slice and that can of Coke, £4.40. It's quite an impressive place. I guess if you like your gardens, why not? But while I'm here, I just thought I'd take the tour. It doesn't cost anything, so I think you'd pay for it through the coffee shop. Let's have a look. I mean, fair enough, there's a lot of time and effort gone into it. I'm enjoying it. Bees? Oh, hello. Oh, I see. Yes, bees. Yeah, honeybees as well. That's probably pretty cool in high winds. And pretty. Yeah, they're a bit more impressive around this side of the garden. Can I get through this? Yeah, again, credit where it's due. They must take some looking after, and there are some very pretty flowers. Yeah, it's not my thing, but I can appreciate what goes into it. It's quite big, it's quite a big area actually. I think I've seen enough. I'm going to make my way out now. So that would suggest that they are all azaleas that I've been looking at there, them last few, the pretty ones. Yo. So that's tomorrow. A shorter one at 14. The centre of Kington, the Swan just up ahead on this left hand path on the corner there is where I'm staying tonight. There's a Royal Oak here as well. So I've got a choice of beds, just booked a single room, but I've got a twin. This one was 50 quid this room tonight. Got a little shelf with teas and coffees as per usual, a little telly. Nice painting. Ensuite, I've not actually looked in here yet. Shower, boil, zinc. So yeah, bog standard. 50 quid. Decent view out of the town, I suppose. Well, of the centre, of the war memorial anyway. So I've picked a good time, it's just trying to rain. There's where I'm staying, and the memorial cross. Now I'm just heading down into the sort of centre here to get some supplies for tomorrow, have a look around really. I have had a walk around Kington. To be fair, there's not a lot here, and what there is closed. It's quite a bit of a rundown place it looks like to me. There's a few shops, a few pubs and a chip shop that's open, and that's about it. So that's probably me signing off for the night. I'll see you tomorrow.